Hey, what's going on, y'all? Look, man, shit, got a little time on my hand, man. I said I'm gonna talk about some interesting things this year. You know what I'm saying? You know, I be seeing a lot of people. Oh, if you love Jesus, you love God, and then they be sending these little things. You know, spread it around. If you love Jesus, you love God. Spread this on Facebook. You know, whatever. Social sites, they be fanning that stuff around. They be trying to trick people like they know God. You know what I'm saying? Like they know Yahshua or Jesus. You know what I'm saying? Like they know him. Like they thought they be playing. But anyway, man. I was sitting back and I say, you know what? For anybody who believe in the Bible, if you have to read Deuteronomy chapter 28 alone, you finna get some history. I'm talking about, that's a juicy story. I'm just gonna tell you a little bit, cause I know y'all gonna take the time and read it yourselves, especially y'all Christians, cause that's y'all Bible, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, if you take the time to read Deuteronomy chapter 28 alone, boy, that's a juicy story. I'm talking about a juicy story. I'm talking about, now, I'm a history person. And like they say, if you don't know your history, it'll repeat itself. So, you know, I've always been big on history. So, I personally think and really know that the Hebrew people were black. You know what I'm saying? When they flee from Israel and they got conquered from the Rome, because see, the Rome bucked on them. You know what I'm saying? They were doggone conquered by the Rome, you know, the Romans. You know, when the Rome came into power, it was called the Dark Ages. You know what I'm saying? Rome brought Christian with them. They Christianity with them. They brought a lot of stuff. But anyway, we ain't going to go that far. We're just going to talk about the story of Deuteronomy just a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, you know, these Hebrew people, they flee. Millions of them. They flee, and they went down into Africa. Now, mind you, they go down to Africa, they get to blend in because they black. You know what I'm saying? So they went down there, you know, specifically West Africa. You know what I'm saying? That way they got caught. You know what I'm saying? Roman white folk caught their ass. You know what I'm saying? Caught our ass. You know what I'm saying? We got caught, shouted, we flee. Then we flee like a big dog. You know what I'm saying? He like, damn, Sike, why we dog gonna run from no folk? Nigga, we almighty, we powerful. You know what I'm saying? We intelligent. We the indigenous. We been here for a long time. Why we running from them? Well, as the story goes in Deuteronomy, we didn't keep our covenant with our Most High God. You know what I'm saying? And like I say, once you read it, it's going to tell you, man, we worship everybody else's God except our own. So therefore, you know, it's like a curse been placed upon us. You know, it talks about we're going to be taken to the land of the enemy. They're going to have their way with us. They're going to toss us up. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to try to flee and won't be able to get away. You know what I'm saying? Talk about how the doggone oppressor going to doggone, you know what I'm saying? Snatch up our females, you know what I'm saying? Bang them out. You know what I'm saying? Talk about how Iron Rod is going to be around our neck. We're going to be chained up. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be brought over by way of a ship. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be, brought into Egypt, meaning bondage, slavery. You know what I'm saying? So when you read it and it says something about Egypt, that means bondage or slavery, because the original name for the country Egypt is Kemet. Kemet. That's land of the black. You know what I'm saying? So that's the original name. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of these names come from our oppressors, you know what I'm saying? Come from the Germans, come from the Romans, come from the Persians, you know, because them a lot of the people who came and conquered a lot of those countries and got us divided as a people, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, it's talking about doggone how people going to try to, you know what I'm saying, bail us out, you know what I'm saying? They won't be able to bail us out, you know, people such as like, you know, Dr. King, Malcolm X, Marcus Garvey, like everybody who done fought and lost their life was trying to get us up out of the situation we in. So a lot of time when we look at what goes on in this country for us, oh, the whites shooting us. Oh, they shot a kid in the park. Oh, look what they did to Kendrick Johnson and Valdosta. They rode him up in a wrestling mat, and this nigga was at an institution. He was at a school. You know, that, you know, institution meaning one of them places we trust, you know, such as a church, a school, you know, a hospital. Those are institutions, you know what I'm saying? But they ain't ran by us, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, look at Tulsa, Oklahoma, out in Greenwood, a.k.a. Black Wall Street. They had a lot going for them. They were doing they thug thizzle. Man, them white people came through there. Boom, boom. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking, boom, nigga, blowing them up. Nigga, they mobbed on them. You know what I'm saying? They mobbed on us. So like, damn, Shotta, we can't get a break. But the thing is, you know what I'm saying? We bucked the system. You know what I'm saying? So according to the Bible, if that's something you believe in, like, shoot, Moses came Mount Sinai, like, look, man, y'all Most High God say, look, you know what I'm saying? Did what the lick read, you know what I'm saying? Should do y'all concur? You know what I'm saying? Y'all rhyme. They're like, okay, we're going to sign in blood. Yeah, we rocking. And then we bought the system and we didn't. So therefore, a curse been placed upon, you know what I'm saying, the Most High children. You know what I'm saying? Now, he haven't forsaken his children. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you'll be able to look at the book of Psalms, if I recollect correctly. It's like chapter 14. He's not going to forsaken us in a sense, but we got to overcome this burden, this obstacle. You feel me? So a lot of what y'all don't understand, and it's like, man, oppressor keep on, Yeah, you know, y'all whining, crying. You know what I'm saying? The Bible referred to it as murmuring. So that's a lot of what's going on. But when you don't understand the history or you don't understand the story, then you just sitting back and, you know, you just become disease-stricken mentally. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, it's a lot to digest and it's a lot to bear and to overcome. And you don't get it. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, according to doggone Deuteronomy, like I say, I'm keep saying the Deuteronomy 28 alone. It's a juicy story, shout out. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, damn, man, you know, as his people, we done bought the system. So now we seeing back. Look, our name's been taken and everything. Most people got European names. Even Jesus. Like, man, who gave him the name Jesus? Like, come on, man. They changed the name or changed his color. You know what I'm saying? Shout out, if you look at, like, just like they told you in the movie Black Panther, man, the British, they got all of our artifacts. They got thousands and thousands of our artifacts and sculptures, you know, even in Germany, they got Nefertiti. What the hell Nefertiti sculpture doing in Germany? Why is it there? You know what I'm saying? They done stole it. You know what I'm saying? They done mobbed on us. You feel me? So it's like, you know, we dealing with a lot. You know what I'm saying? Our women, you know what I'm saying? They gonna doggone, pretty much, they gonna doggone, not fold, but they gonna become the females who we now see in the day over here in America, shawty. Like, they feminists. They bucking, shawty. They want power, nigga. I'm talking about they competing with the black man. They not saying, you know what, let me be submissive, because me being submissive as a woman, seen not heard, that's gonna do the job more so than bucking and talking out the side of my neck. That's gonna do the job. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you know your value and your worth, you know what I'm saying? And you got a class enough to know how to go about a situation, you know, they wouldn't be dealing with what they're dealing with. But if they're going to get a low-life dude, it's easy to talk to him out the side of your neck and, you know, and lowball him and talk this and that, because it's like he don't know his value. He don't know no better. He's just mooching off of you. And then you want somebody you can slap around. But that's a whole nother story, man. You have to check that out later. But like I say, man, back to that Deuteronomy, man. Deuteronomy and Leviticus, like I say, now mind you, the five books in the Bible is supposed to consist of the Old Testament. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, the Most High God, you know what I'm saying? His word is law. You know, a lot of people are like, oh, that don't work no more. You know, you got to go through with the New Testament. Like, nah, his word is law. His word is law. It don't change, nigga. It don't change. You know what I'm saying? But that, I think that's where the trick come in, that people changing and saying, oh, no, you get to go by this now. Oh, you get to go by that. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, a lot of different religions, you know, jumping into play, like Islam, you know what I'm saying, Christianity, you know what I'm saying? It's like, again, it's not older than doggone the Hebrew, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, if you ever get a chance, and like I say, that's your source of knowledge and that's what you believe in, please check out that particular history right there in Deuteronomy chapter 28, you know what I'm saying? Because it's going in. And like they say, you know, hey, look, y'all going to become a disease-stricken people. You know what I'm saying? Y'all going to be spread it on all four corners of the earth. So when you look at North America, when you look at doggone the whole entire planet, we scattered everywhere. We in London. You know what I'm saying? We in Asia. We everywhere. South America. We in Africa. You know what I'm saying? But the Hebrew people, like I say, the Hebrew people look like the African people. The African people look like the Haitian people. The Haitian people look like the Jamaican people. They all different cultures. You know what I'm saying? But like I say, they, again, man, it is just the same color, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I just want to leave y'all with the last little piece. Black is a label, you know what I'm saying? It's not a nationality. It's not your ethnic background. Black is a color. It's a label, you know what I'm saying? It's not who you are, you know what I'm saying? Shoot, I go and ask a person from Asia over in Cambodia, who are you? Oh, I'm Cambodian. They'll be able to trace their roots. Who are you? Oh, I'm Mandarin. You know, a Chinese person may say I'm Mandarin. Japanese person may say I'm, you know what I'm saying? Like everybody, you know, you go to Nigeria. Oh, I'm such and such. You know, I'm Nigerian. I'm Ghanaian. You know what I'm saying? In Ghana, you know what I'm saying? Like everybody know their background. Shit, man, you got the ones who calling themselves African American over here. They don't know where they come from. So it's like, this is what convinced me Deuteronomy chapter 28 is talking about them. And I know it is, you know what I'm saying? You know, but like I said, if there's something you believe in, then it's going to tell the story, read it, check it out. Like I said, that's my time.